What if the next great city on Earth is not built on land, but buried beneath the sea? Beneath the Red Sea, where pressure can crush steel and sunlight disappears, Saudi Arabia is exploring an idea most nations would never attempt. Not a building, not a base, but an entire underwater district that could change how humans live or prove why we never should have tried. Please take a moment to subscribe and like the video. It really helps the channel. Far below the surface of the Red Sea, sunlight fades, pressure rises, and the ocean becomes hostile to human life. It is a place designed by nature to remain untouched. And yet this is where one nation is asking an extraordinary question. Can a modern society build not just a structure, but an entire district beneath the sea? The idea immediately evokes a familiar myth, Atlantis, a city lost to water, remembered as both a marvel and a warning. But this time, the city is not a legend. It is a proposal, and its success could redefine how humanity expands or trigger consequences we cannot reverse. To understand why this idea exists at all, you have to zoom out. Saudi Arabia is in the middle of one of the most aggressive national transformations in modern history. For decades, the country's economy revolved around oil. Now, that dependency is being dismantled in real time. Vision 2030 aims to reposition the kingdom as a hub for technology, tourism, and experimental urbanism. At the center of this strategy sits NEOM, a vast development zone on the Red Sea designed as a laboratory for ideas that traditional cities would never attempt. Within NEOM, limits are not just pushed, they are deliberately broken. And that is where Aqua Horizon enters the picture, as one of the most radical concepts ever attached to a national development plan. Aqua Horizon is not a single building. It is envisioned as an underwater urban district integrated into NEOM's wider master plan. Early design imagery shows clusters of submerged structures anchored to the seabed, connected by pressurized corridors and illuminated by artificial light. The concept blends habitation, scientific research, and high-end tourism into one controlled underwater environment. This is not about underwater hotels alone. It is about proving that humans can permanently occupy space beneath the sea. The plans remain intentionally flexible, focusing less on final specifications and more on ambition. The message is clear. If this works, it opens an entirely new frontier for cities. The ocean is not neutral territory. It actively resists construction. As depth increases, pressure multiplies, forcing every surface to withstand loads far beyond those faced by skyscrapers. Structures must remain sealed for decades while surrounded by corrosive salt water. Even small failures become catastrophic when repair requires specialized submarines instead of ladders. To counter this, Aqua Horizon relies on sealed underwater domes engineered to distribute pressure evenly, similar to spacecraft operating in reverse. Inside, controlled ecosystems would regulate temperature, oxygen, and humidity. Construction itself would not rely on human divers at scale. Instead, robotic systems would assemble components, inspect joints, and perform maintenance continuously. The technology exists in pieces today, but never at city scale. And scaling it up implies enormous costs and timelines measured in decades rather than years. Engineering can keep structures intact, but humans are not machines. Living underwater introduces psychological and biological challenges that no blueprint can ignore. Natural light disappears. The circadian rhythm relies entirely on artificial cycles. Every breath of air is generated by a system that cannot fail. Food, water, and waste must all operate in closed loops. Even minor disruptions become existential threats in a fully submerged environment. Long-term isolation also carries psychological risks, from anxiety to cognitive decline. The question becomes unavoidable. Is this a sustainable place to live, or a controlled form of isolation made comfortable by technology? Aqua Horizon does not fully answer that yet. Instead, it tests how far humans are willing to adapt when the environment refuses to adapt back. The Red Sea is not an empty void. It is one of the most biologically diverse marine environments on Earth, home to coral reefs that have survived warming oceans better than most in the world. Construction at this scale risks disrupting delicate ecosystems through sediment disturbance, noise pollution, and long-term shading. Developers argue that countermeasures could offset these risks. Artificial reefs could expand marine habitats. Waste isolation systems would prevent contamination. Architecture could be designed to coexist with marine life rather than displace it. But critics point out a deeper issue. Once permanent infrastructure is placed on the seabed, removal becomes nearly impossible. Mistakes underwater do not get second chances. The concern is not initial impact alone, but the permanence of change. Beyond engineering and ecology, Aqua Horizon carries strategic weight. Underwater infrastructure offers scientific leadership in marine research and climate monitoring. It creates a new category of luxury tourism that few nations could replicate. And symbolically, it positions Saudi Arabia as a country willing to build where others hesitate. But the ocean introduces legal uncertainty. International law governs much of the sea, yet long-term submerged developments exist in a gray area. If underwater cities become viable, competition beneath the surface could follow, turning the seabed into the next contested frontier. Aqua Horizon may be experimental today, but it hints at a future where influence extends downward instead of outward. History offers plenty of warnings. Megaprojects often begin with bold promises and glossy renderings. Budgets expand, timelines slip. Some ideas are quietly redesigned. Others are never fully completed. NEOM itself has already faced scrutiny as concepts evolve. Aqua Horizon raises the same question. Is this a functional prototype being developed step by step? Or is it a headline designed to capture attention and signal ambition? The difference matters. Because one represents progress through experimentation, the other risks becoming an expensive symbol without substance. The story of Atlantis has endured for thousands of years because it reflects a recurring human pattern. Build something extraordinary, believe it is permanent, then lose control. Aqua Horizon sits uncomfortably close to that metaphor. The potential rewards are immense. New forms of urban space, scientific breakthroughs, a deeper understanding of how humans interact with extreme environments. But the risks are just as large. Engineering failures below the surface leave no margin for error. Ecological damage could outlast any economic benefit, and human limits cannot always be engineered away. This project forces a difficult balance between ambition and restraint. As the surface of the Red Sea closes overhead, Aqua Horizon remains an idea suspended between possibility and caution. It represents humanity's desire to expand into every remaining frontier. But it also asks whether we should. Building downward instead of outward could relieve pressure on land, or it could create problems deeper than we can reach. The future beneath the surface is uncertain, and whether it becomes humanity's next great chapter or a warning echoing from history is still an open question. Thanks for watching Unthinkable Build. We'll see you in the next one.